zeros of the polynomial. Let p of x be a polynomial. If p of a equal to 0, then we say that a is a zero of the polynomial p of x. That is, p of x be the polynomial. Polynomial we have to consider p of x, g of x, f of x for anyway we have to mention. Let here we have to consider p of x be a polynomial. Instead of x, we have to substitute any value. That substituting time you get the remainder 0, we say that a, what value are substituting here, that is called the polynomial, 0 of the polynomial. Third problem, for first you have to listen to the third problem, then I will teach the first and second problem. Third problem, find the zeros of the polynomial in each of the following. First problem, p of x is equal to x minus 3. Second problem, p of x is equal to 2x plus 5. Third problem, q of y equal to 2y minus 3. Fourth problem, f of z is equal to 8z. Fifth problem, p of x is equal to a into x when a not equal to 0. Sixth one, h of x is equal to ax plus b. A not equal to 0. A comma b belongs to R. Third first problem, given p of x is equal to x minus 3. For this, zeros we want to find. First, we have to check the x minus 3. When we get 0, for minus 3 is there, for the same value change the sign, minus 3, the related value, the opposite sign is plus 3. So p of 3 you have to consider, instead of x you have to substitute 3, 3 minus 3 equal to 0. So p of 3 equal to 0, so this x equal to 3 is 0 of p of x. Second problem, p of x is equal to 2x plus 5, then first you take coefficient of x is there, you take an outside, you have to take outside. 2 take outside, that means x plus 5 by 2. Taken outside, that means it comes as a dividing inside the bracket. So now for this 5 by 2, when we become cancel, when it become cancel, change the sign, the same number, that opposite sign, that is minus 5 by 2. So p of minus 5 by 2 equal to 2 into x value minus 5 by 2. So minus 5 by 2 plus 5 by 2. So it's become cancelled. So that is 2 into 0, 0. So what value we are substituting? We get the remainder 0, minus 5 by 2. So that minus 5 by 2 is the 0 of p of x. So x equal to minus 5 by 2 is the 0 of p of x. Third problem is same as second problem. So now you listen to the fourth problem. F of z is equal to 8 into z. For the product value, for any number multiple with 0, we get 0. So that z value you have to substitute as 0. So 8 into 0, 0. So x equal to 0 is the 0 of f of z. Fifth problem, p of x is equal to a into x. For this also product. So product when we get 0, multiple with 0. So p of 0 equal to a into 0, that is equal to 0. So p of 0 equal to 0, so x equal to 0. X equal to 0 is the 0 of p of x. The last problem, h of x is equal to ax plus b. That is the same as a second problem. For 2 is a coefficient is a. So a take outside. So that is x plus what value taken outside, that you write it as in the denominator, b by a. So for this p by a, their opposite value is minus p by a. Minus b by a you have to consider, that is a into minus b by a plus b by a, that is 0. A into 0, 0. So this minus b by a is the 0 of h of x. Now first problem, find the value of the polynomial f of y equal to 6y minus 3y square plus 3. We have, in this polynomial we have to substitute these three values, y equal to 1, then y equal to minus 1, then y equal to 0. Then we simplify the answer. Given polynomial is 6y minus 3y square plus 3. First question, we have to substitute the value y equal to 1. So f of 1 equal to where you have y, instead of y you have to substitute the value 1. 6 into 1, 3 into 1 whole square plus 3. So 6 into 1, 6, 3 into 1 square value 1. So that is 6 minus 3 plus 3. Minus 3 plus 3 cancel. That means 0. So answer 6. Then y equal to minus 1. 6 into minus 1, y value minus 1. So you have to substitute minus 1 minus 3 into minus 1 whole square plus 3. So 6 into minus 1, minus 6, minus 3, minus 1 whole square value 1. So minus 3, minus 3 into 1, minus 3, plus 3, plus 3 minus 3 cancel, so minus 6, then y equal to 0, 6 into 0, minus 3 into 0, plus 3, for 6 into 0, 0, minus 3 into 0, 0, plus 3, so it's become 3. Second problem, if p of x is equal to x square minus 2 into root 2 into x plus 1, find p of 2 root 2. The x value we have to substitute, instead of x we have to substitute 2 into root 2. Second problem is important question, repeated question. First you write the given polynomial, we have to substitute the value 2 into root 2, that is 2 root 2 whole square minus 2 root 2 already given. For this x value, 1 more 2 root 2 plus 1. Now 2 into root 2 whole square, 2 square value 4, root 2 square, root 2 into root 2, 2. Now you have to multiply 2, 2 sum 4, root 2 into root 2, 2 plus 1. 4 into 4, 2 are 8, 4, 2 are 8 plus 1, plus 8 minus 8 cancel, the answer become 1. For now, we have to find the 0 of the polynomial graphically. So now you have to consider the graph. First one is given, one straight line, another second diagram is a curve line. For in these two diagram, how you got to find the number of zeros? For the line, straight line or curve line, intersect on the x-axis in a how many distinct points, that we have to calculate, that is called the number of zeros. So that is, the number of zeros depend on the line or curves intersecting on the x-axis. For the line intersect here, one place. For in this diagram, intersect at two places, that is here and here. So the number of zeros here, 1. Number of zeros for this diagram, 2. Sixth problem, find the zeros of the following polynomial represented by their graphs. First question, we have to find for the curves intersect at how many points on the x-axis. For here, 1, 2. So number of zeros, 2. For this curve intersect, 1, 2, 3. We have to consider only x-axis, 1, 2, 3. So number of zeros, 3. For the third problem, the curve cannot touch the x-axis. So the number of zeros, 0. For not intersect at the x-axis. Next, fourth problem, the curve intersect on the x-axis at only one point. So number of zeros, 1. The fifth problem, for the curve is intersect at one point on the x-axis. So number of zeros is equal to 1.